por aquí fuera.
Okay, so hello. It's May 7th, Sunday, about 5 p.m. and I am done with my race, or I've been done with my race for a good, well, probably 3.5 hours. I think I finished like 12:30. Wait, how many hours is that? No, or 1:30. I think I've been done almost 4 hours now. And I thought to do my race recap already today, because all the emotions are still fresh on my mind and it's a fresh experience. And I think I'm just gonna be super honest with this, so just I apologize if this is going to be super negative or just complaining about things and coming up with excuses for my performance. But I wanted to just talk about my race, vlog about my race when I still kind of remember everything. So, okay, so I woke up this morning and I wasn't feeling great. Like, this hip thing that I have been dealing with this week just did not feel good. But like, I knew like it might feel a little bit today, but I felt it more than I felt yesterday, and my quads just felt super empty. Like, I don't know why, because I rested pretty much all day yesterday. I don't think I rolled them out too aggressively yesterday or anything, so I just don't know why my legs just felt so like ugh. Anyways, ate breakfast, had a little bit of gut issues. So I've been having gut issues all week, and I don't know if anyone knows, or some people know, I have an IBS. I've always had super sensitive stomach, so like having gut issues is kind of like more normal to me than for, I guess, for an average person. But I've been actually having like some weird things going on in my belly this week, and I think it's probably because of the bacterial change between Finland and Spain, even though I haven't been drinking the tap water. But still, like, cooking with the tap water, or, you know, going to get a smoothie and they might have made ice cubes with the tap water, I don't know. So I've had some gut things going on. This morning wasn't any better, and I had to take Imodium before the race, which is also, you know, it is what it is. But it was not nice to, like, you know, have the gut things going on this morning too, and I felt like that probably is one reason why my legs were feeling kind of flat. Anyways, we went to do the transition stuff, like put everything ready, and then I did a swim warm-up. And I don't know, I mean, I felt my legs kind of doing the warm-up, but I was like, okay, like, once the race starts, I'm just gonna like forget about everything. Well, the race started and I got absolutely rolled by all the women at the very beginning of the race. Like, everyone was just like, you know, like swimming over me, like pulling me backwards and like punching and kicking my face, and I was just trying to get to the first buoy, and I like literally had to stop once during the like the first like 200 meters because people were just like, you know, swimming over me and kicking, and like I couldn't like I was like just so disoriented. And then like I like was like not in a great position, but I was like, okay, you know what, I'm swimming my own race, like just focus on getting to the buoys. And first it was kind of hard because we were swimming against the rising sun, so I couldn't really see anything, so I was just trying to like see where everyone else was going. Then we turned around, and then I felt like the waves were just like worse on the way back. So I couldn't like see the buoys because like every time I looked up, there was a wave going like over me basically, just like, or like above my like level of sight. So then I was just trying to see like, okay, where's everyone else going? And I felt like I took my like line a little bit too wide, so I probably swam a little bit more than I should have, but I wasn't wearing my watch actually. So this was the first time I decided that I'm just not going to swim with the watch, because it's always, you know, like pressing the buttons and like trying to get the sweat, and then like going to the ride, and then like trying to save your swim, and then coming to the run and trying to like toggle and find your run. So I decided that I'm just going to have my watch for the run only. So I left it in the run bag. But yeah, so I passed a couple pro men at the end of the swim, which was like a win. And I felt like my swim was not good. I couldn't find like the heart rhythm. I was just kind of like comfortably steady all the time. And well, I was glad to learn later that I did go under 30 minutes for the first time in the 7.3 swim. So my time was 29:54. And so I knew I had improved my swim during the winter. So now it was just kind of nice to see that even with a shitty, but even with a bad day, I can still PR. So like, I guess that's like giving me some hope that next time is going to be better. Yeah, the typical hassle of the transition. So I forgot to put any like Vaseline in my wrist and ankles like I normally do to get my wetsuit off easier. So it was kind of like difficult to get off my wetsuit, and then I was just like scrambling. I had a new kit, so I raced in my club kit, which was like a totally new kit that I got this year, and the pockets were different from my previous kits. And I couldn't like get the gels in the little pockets at the back, so that was also exciting. I was running towards my bike and trying to just like jam them in, and they wouldn't go in. I got on the bike, my legs just not good. Like I had already like felt my heavy legs and hip flexor cramping during the swim, and I started the bike and I did not feel any better. So I was like, great, this is gonna be a lovely ride, especially because the first like 18 kilometers, like there's like a 10 kilometer uphill, and I literally just did not feel good. So I was like, okay, we'll see how this goes. But surprisingly, I rode a very good power for me, like my best 70.3 power ever, despite like there being long downhill stretches, like basically 0 watts. So my average power, like the absolute average power and the normalized power, were both like better than any time before. So that's exciting, but the thing is that I got passed by women and like left and right, just like despite me riding my best power. And I'm like, I'm not saying this, like it's like obviously like every professional woman is probably like competitive, but I think, you know, I consider myself as a decent rider. My 20-minute power is lower 5 watts per kilo, so like I was riding threshold power basically up the hills, and then like holding my target watts of like 200-210 for the flats, and then taking the descents, actually like quite brave for me. And I still got like passed, and like you know, my time wasn't quite as good, so that was quite disappointing for me. And just shows that I really need to focus on the aero gains that I'm missing right now if I want to succeed at this level. So it's just a must. But yeah, so legs didn't feel good. I had some nutrition like issues, or like absorption issues. Like I felt like I'm just like I didn't digest super well. I was trying to drink a lot, did my normal nutrition, but still kind of like burped up the gels all the time, which was kind of gross. But yeah, I don't know, we climbed 1400 meters, which is like the most I've ever done in a race. I did my best power. I, you know, descended brave for me and still didn't make any time. Like I lost time during the ride. So So that was disappointing for sure. Like, I think the good thing is that I was performing at my level basically when it comes to power, but then on the other hand, like, it didn't really translate over to the performance. So there's some work to do, I guess, and I need to figure out my position, I guess, better, and then equipment a little bit more. T2 was quite, like, difficult again. I was scrambling big time, just like trying to put the socks on. I had already formed blisters during the ride, so I definitely wanted to put socks on. Just dropping things and just trying to, like, you know, leave the T2 as fast as possible. It was just a mess. I started the run and yeah, just felt the same, like the work, like as bad as I had felt all day, I still, like, you know, I didn't feel any better. I was quite warm at that point, so my goal just became to, you know, finish the run, yeah, finish the race, you know, and also cool off as much as possible at each aid station. Grab water for drinking, just dump water over myself, grab Red Bull, just anything, you know, all the time. Like, I literally utilized all the aid stations all the time because I just needed to stay cool. Last year, I had a heat stroke in my first 70.3. So today was a hot day and I was a little bit nervous about that. And that's why I was just, you know, paying extra careful attention to drinking a lot, just dumping water over myself. But yeah, so the run was 3 laps, kind of a sandy course. It was like a little tough because of that. So it was like basically 3.5k out, 3.5k back times 3. During the first half of the lap, I accidentally ran my goal pace, so under 4 minutes per k is kind of like my sweet spot pace. I didn't really feel that sweet today. But then, like, you know, after that, I just started gradually slowing down. Legs got worse and I got tired and more tired and just hot. And literally just tried to survive between the aid stations to, like, get more water on me. Then this injury, I guess I should call it an injury now because it really feels not normal. I just felt all the time during the race, like, I just felt it, and I felt like I fell in my knee, I fell in my hip, I fell in my back. So I don't know, I'm a little nervous right now. I need to get it checked when I get home next week. I'm hoping it's just a severe IT band syndrome or, you know, some tendonitis thing, or, you know, but a part of me is just worried that it's that my injury from the fall / winter has renewed. But I'm just trying to stay positive and not get freaked out, completely freaked out, because I'm already freaked out. Try not to get completely freaked out before I have basically got someone to check how things are and got a professional opinion. But yeah, so I made it to the end of the third lap, or I guess I made it to the last turnaround point of the third lap, and I got passed by another woman, and she literally just, like, just, you know, passed me in double the speed I was running, and I had no response. I just tried to survive. So kudos for her for being very strong today in the heat. My goal was to finish within the top half of the race, so we had 24 women starting, and I wanted to finish in top 12, and I finished 18th, and I was about 4 minutes off of being, like, 12th, and I ran about 4 minutes slower than I would have run on my normal day. So that's kind of funny, that maybe on a normal-ish, more normal-ish day, I could have reached my goal. But also, I guess I should say it's encouraging that there wasn't like that much between my position and where I wanted to be today. But yeah, so that's something. I guess I learned a lot. First race is always a rust buster, and I think it's a little tricky right now because I didn't perform the way I was hoping I would, but on the other hand, I could have comfortably won the age group race overall, and it's like it's giving me mixed feelings because I'm questioning myself right now if I made the right decision of going pro this year, when I really, really, really want to race in the Ironman 70.3 World Championships in Finland. So it's like, if I had stayed in the age group for one more year, I could have easily qualified today and won my age group and all age groups. But then on the other hand, my goal and dream has always been to race professionally, and I'm out here doing it. Excuse me. So I'm out here doing it, but it just is a lot more difficult to qualify for the World Championships this year, and I think it's a once in a career situation where you can race the World Championships in your home country. But yeah, I guess I just have to take the lessons from here with me for the next race and see how that goes and keep improving and keep, you know, still enjoying it, even though it's pretty hard. But yeah, that's all. Thanks for watching. See you next time.